We love you, Jesus. You're in this place. You're in this place. We just worship you tonight. Lift your hands up in this place. Just begin to give him your own worship. You give him your own worship in this place. Whatever you want to say to him, just begin to worship him, worship him, worship. Tell him you love him. Just begin to worship him, worship him, worship him in this place. His presence is in this place. Su presencia está aquí. Adóralo. Adóralo, adóralo en tus propias palabras. Of rest for you. The Holy Spirit is in this place. His glory is here. His presence is here. He's in the room. Él está aquí.
He is here.
I get lost in your love. worship you tonight.
Padre, te adoramos en esta noche.
Te adoramos en este día. Eres poderoso, Dios.
You are powerful, God.
You know He's here.
Sabes que está aquí.
Your Father in heaven is in this place.
Tu Padre en el cielo está en este lugar.
I don't think our minds can fathom that.
Yo no creo que nuestras mentes pueden comprender.
Thank you, Jesus. We love you.
Gracias, Jesús, te amamos.
We're here for you.
Estamos aquí para ti.
I just saw a pair of feet.
Acabo de ver un par de pies.
Somebody's, I don't know if you have feet conditions or feet problems.
Yo no sé si tiene condiciones en los pies o problemas con los
but
pies.
God is healing you as you worship God.
Pero Dios te está sanando mientras que tú le adores.
Like I just saw, like I don't know if you have swelling in your feet.
Yo no sé si se le hincha.
God is beginning to heal your feet right now.
Dios le está empezando a sanar los pies ahora.
Thank you, Jesus.
Gracias, Jesús.
Yeah, yeah. Somebody, whoever that's for, receive it right now.
Para quien
thank you,
sea,
Jesus.
Recíbalo ahora.
Thank you, Jesus. Somebody's gracias. Needing deliverance.
Alguien necesita liberación.
Chains are falling.
Las cadenas se caen.
While you're worshiping Him.
Mientras que le adores.
Chains are falling while you're worshiping
Las cadenas
Him.
Se caen mientras que le adores.
Thank you, Jesus.
Gracias,
Father, the Holy Spirit is here healing people.
El Espíritu Santo está aquí, sanando.
Somebody came in with a really serious need.
Alguien entró con una necesidad muy seria.
And only Jesus can heal that.
Y solo Jesús puede sanar eso.
So as you worship Him, God is beginning to work in that situation.
Así que mientras que le adores, Dios empieza a obrar en esa situación.
Thank you, Jesus.
Gracias,
thank
Jesús.
You, thank you, Jesus.
Gracias, Jesús.
We honor you, God.
Te honramos, Dios.
Thank you, Jesus.
Gracias, Jesús.
Gracias.
Thank you.
Isn't God good?
¿Qué Dios no es bueno?
Go and hug 3, 4, 5 people. Welcome them to the house of God.
Vaya a abrazar 3, 4, 5 personas y dele la bienvenida a la casa de Dios.
I've got you for the next 30-40 minutes. Welcome all those that are watching us through live stream.
Bienvenido a todos que nos están viendo a través del live stream.
Come on, can you give them a big shout out?
Vamos, le pueden dar un fuerte aplauso.
To Ignite, to all those that are watching us through live stream.
A todos aquellos que nos están viendo a través del live stream.
We were in Bryan, Texas.
Estábamos en Bryan, Texas.
And it was awesome.
Y fue asombrante.
So the last session was.
La última sesión fue.
It was crazy. It was crazy fire.
Fue de locura. Fue fuego de locura.
I had people tell me that they were going to give up in God,
yo tenía
but they felt God's presence so strong.
Que estaban desanimados y que se iban a dar por vencidos, pero sintieron la presencia de Dios muy fuerte.
And every time I leave a place,
y cada vez que yo me voy de un lugar,
it rains.
Yo, llueve.
And at first I thought it was funny.
Y al principio yo pensaba que era
chistoso. So we would joke about it.
Así que hacemos broma de eso.
But then it really does storm.
Pero en realidad sí llega la tormenta.
There was such a shift in that place.
Y hubo tal cambio en ese lugar.
To tell you I couldn't come home because the thunder, it was like almost it was a huge thunderstorm that came.
Para decirle que casi no llegaba a casa porque había una tormenta fuerte.
And so I'm getting all these testimonies of people who their whole their city just feels like it was in transition.
Estoy recibiendo testimonios que la ciudad, la gente siente que la ciudad hubo una transición completa.
So there were so many testimonies. So give Jesus a big shout out. Thank you for praying for me.
Hubo tantos testimonios, así que dele un fuerte aplauso a Jesús. Gracias por orar por mí.
You know, I was praying for you.
Estaba orando por usted.
And I was asking God, I just feel like this church.
Y le estaba pidiendo a Dios, yo siento que esta iglesia.
And the team went with us.
Y el equipo fue con nosotros.
Sorry, I got off track. But the team went with us.
El equipo fue con nosotros.
And all I can say is that you are a very blessed church.
Y todo lo que yo puedo decir es que usted es una iglesia muy bendecida.
You have the glory of God in this place.
Tiene la gloria de Dios en este lugar.
You get to come in here and enjoy the wonderful presence of God and worship Him.
Puede llegar aquí y disfrutar la hermosa presencia de Dios y adorarle.
You know, most places have closed heavens.
La mayoría de las dos lugares tienen los cielos cerrados.
But you get to come here every single week and enjoy the beautiful glory of God.
Y puede usted venir aquí cada semana y disfrutar la gloria hermosa de Dios.
So I was praying for you because there's such a transition in our church.
Estaba orando por usted porque hay tal transición en nuestra iglesia.
And I feel like your faith level is increasing.
Y yo siento que su nivel de fe está aumentando.
And I need to teach you how to exercise that faith.
Yo tengo que enseñarle cómo ejercer esa fe.
And I wish I had weights up here, because if I had weights up here, I'd teach you or I'd show you how to strengthen your faith.
Quisiera tener pesas acá arriba porque yo le enseñaría cómo fortalecer su fe.
As a matter of fact, say it. I need to strengthen my faith.
De hecho, dígalo. Tengo que fortalecer mi fe.
Say it one more time. Strengthening my faith.
Dígalo una vez más. Fortaleciendo mi fe.
God speaks to us a lot about believing.
Dios nos habla mucho acerca del creer.
God speaks to us a lot about that he's the God of the impossible.
Dios nos habla mucho acerca de que él es el Dios del imposible.
Levánteme la mano si tiene una imposibilidad en esta noche.
Lift up your hand if you have an impossibility tonight.
Raise it up. Raise Levántela. It up. You know that only God can do it.
Usted sabe que solo Dios lo puede hacer.
So then you need to hear this message.
Así que usted tiene que escuchar este mensaje.
I probably won't finish it.
Quizá no lo termine.
Because I have a lot of points.
Porque tengo muchos puntos.
But I'll give you 3-4.
Pero le daré 3-4.
I want to talk to you about strengthening your faith.
Le quiero hablar de fortalecer su fe.
Because God speaks to us a lot about the impossible becoming possible.
Porque Dios nos habla mucho de lo imposible ser posible.
As a matter of fact, Jesus spoke to us a lot about believing.
De hecho, Jesús nos habló mucho acerca del creer.
And he said everything is possible to him that believes.
Y dijo, todo es posible para aquel que cree.
And in the Bible, the Jews became so concerned with the law that they kind of put aside belief.
Y en la Biblia los judíos se preocuparon mucho por la ley que pusieron al lado la fe.
But I want you to read Ephesians 6:16.
Pero creo que quiero que lea Efesios 6:16.
And read it out loud with me.
Léalo fuerte conmigo.
In addition to all this,
además de todo esto,
take up the shield of faith.
Tomen el escudo de la fe.
With which you can extinguish all the flaming arrows of the evil one.
Con el cual pueden apagar todas las flechas encendidas del maligno.
So Paul speaks of spiritual warfare.
Así que Pablo habla acerca de la guerra espiritual.
And he says, take up your shield of faith.
Y dice, tomen el escudo de la fe.
So if you're going to have strong faith.
Así que si va a tener fe fuerte.
You if you're going to have strong faith, say strong faith.
Si va a tener fe fuerte, diga fe fuerte.
You can only have strong faith.
Solo puede tener fe fuerte.
If you strengthen it.
Si la fortalece.
And if you don't have strong faith.
Y si no tiene fe fuerte.
You're going to be very vulnerable.
Va a ser muy vulnerable.
To the lies.
A las mentiras.
And to the attacks of the enemy.
Y a los ataques del enemigo.
So to have strong faith.
Así que para tener la fe fuerte.
How many of you want to live enemy proof?
¿Cuántos de ustedes quieren ser libres del ataque del enemigo?
I mean, you're enemy proof.
Usted es puede pasar cualquier ataque del enemigo.
When the lies are attacking you,
cuando las mentiras le atacan,
you don't easily give into that.
No fácilmente se cae a eso.
We need strong faith for 2 reasons.
Tenemos que tener fuerte fe por 2 razones.
Number one,
número uno,
so that you can extinguish every lie of the enemy.
Para extinguir toda mentira del enemigo.
It is called the shield of faith. Say the shield of faith.
Se llama el escudo de la fe. Diga escudo de la fe.
So your faith guards your heart.
Así que su fe guarda su corazón.
It guards you from any lie.
Lo guarda de cualquier mentira.
From any arrow that would want to penetrate you or your family.
De cualquier flecha que quiere penetrarle a usted o a su familia.
Matter of fact, in Roman times,
de hecho, en los tiempos romanos,
the shield,
el escudo,
that they would use,
que usaban,
was 3 feet high and 3 feet wide.
Era de 3 pies de alto y 3 pies de ancho.
It was a huge shield.
Era un escudo enorme.
And it was impossible.
Y era imposible.
For the enemy to shoot arrows at them.
Para que el enemigo echara flechas hacia ellos.
And penetrate them.
Y penetrarle.
Because the shield was so protective.
Porque el escudo era tan protectivo.
The shield of faith is your protection.
El escudo de la fe es su protección.
So if you're going to have strong faith.
Así que si va a tener la fe fuerte.
You must guard it with the shield of faith.
Tiene que guardarlo con el escudo de la fe.
So number two,
así que número dos,
the reason why we need strong faith,
la razón por la cual necesitamos la fe
fuerte, is for God to move powerfully in your life.
Es para que Dios se mueva poderosamente en su vida.
God cannot move in your life without faith.
Dios no se puede mover en su vida sin la fe.
So if God is going to advance in your life,
así que si Dios va a avanzar en su vida,
and if God is going to do miracles in your life,
y si Dios va a hacer milagros en su vida,
and if His kingdom is going to be advanced,
y si su reino va a ser avanzado,
and if we're going to move mountains,
y si vamos a mover montañas,
you must have strong faith.
Tiene que tener la fe fuerte.
He's a mountain moving God.
Es un Dios que mueve montañas.
The Bible says this.
La Biblia dice,
if you have faith as small as a mustard seed.
Si tiene la fe el tamaño de una semilla de mostaza.
A small mustard seed.
Una semilla de mostaza
He's
pequeña.
Not even asking you to have great faith, just a little bit of faith.
No le está pidiendo que tenga gran fe, nomás un poco de fe.
Can move a mountain.
Puede mover montaña.
And so here I want you to look at the book of Genesis.
Aquí yo quiero que vea el libro de Génesis.
Because in the book of Genesis,
porque en el libro de Génesis,
we find here that Abraham is the father of faith.
Encontramos aquí que Abraham es el padre de la fe.
But in the book of Genesis chapter 15,
pero en el libro de Génesis 15,
the great Abraham,
el gran Abraham,
the father of the faith,
el padre de la fe,
the one that said by faith,
el que dijo por fe,
the one that said that it was his faith that was credited to him as righteousness,
el que dijo que su fe lo acreditó a la justicia.
In about Genesis chapter 15,
en Génesis 15,
he struggled with fears,
estaba luchando con temores,
and he struggled with doubts.
Y luchaba con deudas.
The great Abraham,
el gran Abraham,
had fear,
tenía temor,
and had doubts,
y tenía duda.
And God begins to strengthen his faith.
Y Dios empezó a fortalecer su fe.
So from verse 1 all the way to verse 18,
así que del versículo 1 al 18,
you got to go home and read it.
Tiene que llegar a casa a leerlo.
But Abraham starts to wrestle within himself.
Pero Abraham empezó a luchar entre sí.
And in verse 7,
y en el versículo 7,
God tells him,
Dios le dice,
I am the Lord,
yo soy el
who
Señor
brought you out of Ur,
que te hizo salir de Ur.
He said to take this land as your possession.
Que tomara esta tierra como su posesión.
And if you read verse 19 to 20, Abraham asked God a question.
Abraham le preguntó una pregunta.
How am I going to know,
¿cómo voy a saber,
that you're really going to do what you promised me?
Que en realidad vas a ver lo que me prometiste.
How will I know,
¿cómo sabré?
In other words, show me.
En otras palabras, muéstrame.
Because you told me that I'm going to be,
porque tú me dijiste que yo iba a ser,
a father of many nations.
Un padre de muchas naciones.
And then you also told me, God,
y también me dijiste, Dios,
that you were going to give me land to possess.
Que me ibas a dar tierra a poseer.
But he asked a question because he began to doubt.
Pero preguntó una pregunta porque empezó a dudar.
And he had fears.
Y tenía temores.
In Genesis chapter 15,
en Génesis 15,
the great man of faith,
el gran hombre de la fe,
asked the Lord a question.
Preguntó al Señor una pregunta.
How are you going to do it?
¿Cómo lo vas a hacer?
How will this be done?
¿Cómo será hecho esto?
Abraham asked this question.
Abraham preguntó esta pregunta.
And he says this.
Y dijo esto.
How will I know?
¿Cómo sabré?
How will I know?
¿Cómo sabré?
See, he wasn't questioning God's character.
No estaba cuestionando el carácter de Dios.
He was being honest with God.
Era honesto con Dios.
So I'm going to give you 4 points to strengthen your faith.
Así que le voy a dar 4 puntos para fortalecer su fe.
But there's like 10.
Pero
but I'm going to give
diez.
You 4. You
pero
ready?
Le voy a dar 4. ¿Listo?
How do I exercise my faith?
¿Cómo ejercito mi fe?
Number 1.
Número uno.
If you're going to strengthen your faith,
si va a fortalecer su fe,
you must be honest.
Tiene que ser honesto.
Say, I must be honest.
Diga, tengo que ser honesto.
In the presence of God,
en la presencia de Dios,
when you are before your Father,
cuando está ante su Padre,
you must be honest.
Tiene que ser honesto.
1 Peter 5:7.
Primera de Pedro 5,
says,
7.
Cast your cares before the Lord.
Dice, echa todas tus preocupaciones ante el
because
Señor.
Because He cares for you.
Porque Él cuida de ti.
Cast your cares.
Echa todas tus
preocupaciones. Cast your anxieties.
Echa tu ansiedad.
Before the Lord.
Ante el Señor.
That word care.
Esa palabra preocupación.
Anxiety.
Ansiedad.
It means to divide.
Dice, quiere decir dividir.
Say to divide.
Diga, dividir.
In other words, bring everything to God.
En otras palabras, trae todo a Dios.
That divides your mind.
Que divide tu mente.
That divides your heart.
Que divide tu corazón.
Everything that keeps you from fully trusting God.
Todo lo que no te deja confiar completamente en Dios.
Give it to God.
Dáselo a Dios.
Cast it.
Échalo.
Throw it to Him.
Échaselo.
And leave it there.
Y déjalo ahí.
And here is this great Abraham,
y aquí está este gran Abraham,
and he begins to say, how is it going to be?
Y empieza a decir, ¿cómo va a ser?
When God told Moses,
cuando Dios le dijo a Moisés,
I'm going to use you,
te voy a usar,
to rescue Israel,
para rescatar a Israel.
You know what he said to God?
¿Sabe lo que le dijo a
he
Dios?
Didn't believe him.
No le creyó.
He said, do you realize I stutter?
Dijo, ¿te das cuenta que yo tartamudeo?
You want me to go before the Pharaoh, but I stutter.
¿Tú quieres que yo vaya ante el faraón, pero yo
tartamudeo? The Bible says,
y la Biblia dice,
that God strengthened Moses' faith.
Que Dios fortaleció la fe de Moisés.
You've got to be honest.
Tiene que ser honesto.
God,
Dios,
I'm scared.
Tengo miedo.
God,
Dios,
I don't know how to do it.
Yo no sé cómo hacerlo.
See, when you come before God,
cuando usted viene ante Dios,
you come as a son and a daughter and you be transparent before Him.
Viene como un hijo, una hija, y es transparente
and
ante
cast
él.
All your anxieties
y echa toda su ansiedad.
And everything that is dividing you
y todo lo que te divide
from believing God,
de creerle a Dios,
just cast it on Him.
Simplemente échaselo.
How will I strengthen my faith?
¿Cómo fortalezco mi fe?
Number two,
número
write
dos,
it down.
Escríbalo.
Respond to Him in faith.
Responda a él en fe.
Say, I must respond in faith.
Diga, yo tengo que responder en fe.
Dilo, tengo que responder en fe.
Say it, I've got to respond in faith.
Even if you don't understand it,
aunque no lo entiendas,
respond in faith.
Responde en fe.
Even if you don't have all the details,
aunque no tengas todos los detalles,
respond in faith.
Responde en fe.
Abraham asked God,
Abraham le preguntó a
Dios, how will I know?
¿Cómo voy a saber?
Moses said,
Moisés dijo,
you do know that I stutter.
Sí sabes que yo tartamudeo.
Mary,
María,
in the book of Luke chapter 1,
en el libro de Lucas 1,
when the angel says you will give birth to the Savior,
cuando el ángel dijo tú vas a dar a luz,
how is this going to be?
¿Cómo va a ser esto?
They're not questioning God's character.
No están cuestionando el carácter de
they
Dios.
Just want confirmation.
No más quieren confirmación.
There's a difference.
Hay una diferencia.
With asking God how,
como, con preguntar a Dios cómo,
questioning his character,
y cuestionar su carácter.
Or asking God,
o preguntarle a Dios,
God,
Dios,
I believe you,
te creo,
but help my unbelief.
Pero ayuda a mi incredulidad.
How will you do it?
¿Cómo lo harás?
See, I know the character of my husband.
Yo conozco el carácter de mi esposo.
And anytime I come from out of town,
y cualquier tiempo que yo salga
he's
going
to be
ciudad,
at the airport to pick me up.
Él va a estar en el aeropuerto para recogerme.
But there's been times where I'm like, are you sure? Make sure you get there.
Pero hay tiempos cuando yo le pregunto, ¿estás seguro?
I'm not asegúrate. Questioning his character.
Yo no estoy cuestionando su carácter.
I just want to make sure.
Yo no más quiero.
And these men of God,
y estos hombres de Dios,
did not question God's character.
No estaban cuestionando el
carácter de Dios. They responded in faith.
Respondieron en fe.
They just wanted confirmation.
No más querían confirmación.
These people still had faith.
Esta gente todavía tenía fe.
How will I know, God, that you will do it?
¿Cómo sabré, Dios, que tú lo harás?
See, I know that they had faith by how God responds to them.
Yo sabía, yo sé que ellos tienen fe por cómo Dios les responde a ellos.
He doesn't rebuke them.
No los reprende.
He doesn't discipline them.
Él no los disciplina.
He just gives them a response.
Simplemente les da una respuesta.
On the other hand,
de la otra manera,
Zachariah,
Zacarías,
John the Baptist's dad,
el papá de Juan el Bautista,
he questioned God.
Cuestionó a Dios.
And the Bible says,
y la Biblia dice,
that when Elizabeth,
que cuando Elizabeth,
who could not be pregnant,
que no se podía embarazar,
is pregnant,
se embarazó,
the same time as Mary who's carrying Jesus,
a la misma vez que María estaba cargando
the
a Jesús,
Bible says,
la Biblia dice,
an angel appeared to Zachariah.
Un ángel apareció a Zacarías.
Hey, if an angel appeared to you, you would think that you would believe God.
Uno pensaría que si un ángel le apareciera, le creerían a Dios.
And Zachariah looking at the angel face to face,
y Zacarías viendo al ángel cara a cara,
he did not believe God.
No le creyó a Dios.
And because of that,
y por causa de
the
eso,
Bible says,
la Biblia dice,
that God sent a mute spirit to shut his mouth.
Que Dios envió un espíritu mudo para callar su boca.
And he could not speak.
Y no podía hablar.
God disciplined him.
Dios lo disciplinó.
Because he doubted him.
Porque le dudó a él.
There's a difference.
Hay una diferencia.
Between believing God.
Entre creerle a Dios.
And asking him how will this be?
Y preguntarle cómo será
can
esto.
Can you give me a confirmation?
¿Me puedes dar una confirmación?
Can you give me a dream?
¿Me puedes dar un sueño?
I believe you, God.
Yo te creo,
but
Dios.
But just help my unbelief.
Pero ayuda a mi incredulidad.
Versus you doubting God.
Versus usted.
Are you hearing what I'm saying?
Está escuchando
we've
lo que
got
yo digo.
To believe God.
Tenemos que creerle
and
a Dios.
The only way you're going to believe God
y la única manera que le va a creer
is
a Dios.
If you have a relationship with Him.
Es si usted tiene una relación con él.
Number three.
Número
how
tres.
Do I strengthen my faith?
¿Cómo fortalezco mi fe?
To strengthen your faith,
para fortalecer su fe,
you must be obedient.
Tiene que ser obediente.
Levanta tus manos y di tengo que estar obediente.
Lift up your hands and say I've got to be obedient.
Dilo.
Say it.
Your faith will never work in disobedience.
Tu fe nunca va a trabajar en desobediencia.
I don't care who you are.
No me importa quién
you
tú
can
eres.
Say you love God.
Puedes decir que amas
but
a
if
Dios.
You stray from God
pero si te alejas a Dios,
and you're disobedient,
y eres desobediente,
you don't have faith to believe God.
No tienes fe para creerle
it
a Dios.
Is impossible and it is against the word of God.
Es imposible y es en contra de la palabra
to
de Dios.
Believe God,
para creerle a Dios,
there has to be obedience in your life.
Tiene que haber obediencia en tu vida.
Faith without obedience does not exist.
La fe sin obediencia no existe.
You must be obedient.
Tiene que ser
in Genesis 15,
en Génesis 15
Abraham God tells Abraham,
Dios le dice a Abraham
bring me a heifer
tráeme una ternera
bring me a goat
tráeme una cabra
bring me a ram
tráeme un carnero
and offer them unto me
y ofrécelos a
and
mí.
Abraham obeyed immediately
y Abraham obedeció inmediatamente
even when he did not know
aun cuando no sabía
Abraham says how will I know
Abraham dijo cómo sabré
and God said to him
y Dios le dijo
bring me a goat
tráeme una ternera
bring me a ram
tráeme una cabra
bring me a heifer
tráeme una, un carnero
and Abraham
y Abraham
does immediate obedience.
Él fue obediente inmediatamente.
See, most people
la mayoría de la
that
gente
begin to doubt God
empiezan a dudar a Dios.
They start to disobey Him.
Empiezan a desobedecerle.
They start to stop praying.
Empiezan a dejar de orar.
They stop listening to the voice of God.
Dejan de oír la voz de Dios.
They stop seeking God.
Dejan de buscar a Dios.
They drop out.
Se van.
And it will destroy your faith.
Y va a destruir tu fe.
Faith without works, the Bible says, is dead.
La fe sin las obras, la Biblia dice, está muerta.
Disobedience.
La desobediencia
will always weaken your faith.
Siempre va a ser débil tu fe.
Always.
Siempre.
If you are disobedient,
si eres desobediente,
to what God has said to you,
a lo que Dios te ha dicho,
it will weaken your faith.
Va a ser tu fe.
That's why you're doubting.
Por eso estás dudando.
Because you're disobedient.
Porque eres desobediente.
Disobedience causes you to lose faith.
La desobediencia causa que tú pierdas la fe.
And ultimately losing the blessing.
Y últimamente perdiéndote de la bendición.
But when you are obedient,
pero cuando eres obediente,
God gives you more faith.
Dios te da más fe.
And more faith.
Y más fe.
Sometimes he'll say to you,
a veces él te
to
dirá,
do certain things,
que hagas ciertas cosas,
and it doesn't make sense.
Y no tiene sentido.
Just obey him.
Simplemente obedece.
Just obey him.
Simplemente obedece.
And watch how faith will increase.
Y mira cómo la fe aumentará.
Abraham would obey God.
Abraham obedecía a Dios.
Even if he did not understand.
Aunque no entendía.
When you obey,
cuando tú obedeces,
more faith is given unto you.
Más fe es dada a ti.
Peter said this.
Pedro dijo esto.
Jesus.
Jesús.
If it is you,
si eres tú,
bid me to come.
Llámame que vaya.
I want to walk on water.
Yo quiero caminar sobre el
agua. And he obeyed God.
Y obedeció a Dios.
Jesus told him.
Jesús le dijo.
Come.
Ven.
And Peter came out of the boat.
Y Pedro salió del
and he started to walk on water.
Y empezó a caminar
because
sobre
your
el agua.
Obedience
porque su obediencia
will always increase in faith.
Siempre aumentará la fe.
Your obedience
tu obediencia
will cause faith to increase.
Causará que la fe aumente.
Just look at the Bible.
Mire la Biblia.
It's full of examples.
Está lleno de ejemplos.
God told Gideon.
Dios le dijo a Gedeón.
He said, "You've got too many in your army."
Le dijo, "Tienes demasiados en tu ejército."
Get rid of all of those that have fear.
Deshazte de todos los que tienen temor.
And Gideon obeyed.
Y Gedeón obedeció.
And because he obeyed,
y por causa de la
he fought an army of 30,000 men.
Él peleó en contra un ejército de 30,
and he
hombres.
Won the battle.
Y ganó la guerra.
Because obedience,
porque la obediencia
will always cause your faith to rise.
Siempre causará que tu fe se aumente.
He told Joshua,
le dijo a Josué,
just march around the walls of Jericho.
Marcha alrededor de los muros de Jericó.
But how are you going to do it?
Pero ¿cómo lo vas a hacer?
Just obey me.
Simplemente obedéceme.
Just march around. And you'll see that the walls will fall.
Y verás que los muros caerán.
Elijah.
Elías.
God told Elijah,
Dios pray, Elías, ora,
pray,
ora,
and pray
y ora,
until the rain falls.
Hasta que la lluvia
until
caiga,
you hear the sound of rain.
Hasta que escuches el sonido
you've got
de la lluvia.
To keep obeying God, church.
Tienes que seguir obedeciendo a Dios, iglesia.
In the good and in the bad.
En lo bueno y en lo malo.
You have to keep obeying God.
Tienes que seguir obedeciendo a
Dios. Even if
Dios.
You don't understand.
Aunque no lo entiendas.
Obedécelo. Responde a lo que Él te está diciendo.
Respond to what He's telling you.
Y verás que la fe aumenta.
And you will see that the faith increases.
And you will believe Him for great things.
Y le creerás por cosas grandes.
And when you need the mountain to move,
y cuando necesitas que la montaña
you can
se mueva,
speak to the mountain.
Le puedes hablar a
and
la montaña,
it shall move.
Y se moverá.
You can speak to situations and they shall move.
Y se moverán.
He is a God of impossibilities.
Él es el Dios de imposibilidades.
Abraham obeyed God.
Abraham obedeció a Dios.
Even in his doubt.
Aún en su duda.
Even in his fear.
Aún en su temor.
He just said, I don't know how.
Dijo, yo no sé cómo.
But I'm going to obey my father.
Pero yo voy a obedecer a mi padre.
You cannot
no puede
have faith
tener fe
in disobedience.
En desobediencia.
Impossible.
Imposible.
The disobedience will always cause your faith to lack and weaken.
Siempre causará que tu fe sea débil.
And lastly,
y por último,
if you're going to strengthen your faith,
si vas a fortalecer tu fe,
you must continually experience God's presence.
Tienes que continuamente experimentar la presencia de
in
Dios.
Genesis chapter 15,
en Génesis 15,
we find there that God appears to Abraham,
encontramos ahí que Dios aparece a Abraham
through a smoking fire pot,
a través de un fuego,
a blazing torch.
Una torcha en,
God
encendida.
Would appear.
Dios aparecía.
Cloud by day and fire by night.
La nube de día, el fuego por noche.
If God showed up to you,
si Dios se aparecería a ti,
would your faith strengthen?
Se fortalecería tu fe?
If an angel showed up in front of you,
si un ángel apareció enfrente de ti,
would your faith strengthen?
Se fortalecería tu fe?
That's what His presence does.
Eso es lo que su presencia hace.
His presence strengthens your faith.
Su presencia fortalece tu fe.
It's when God manifests His glory.
Así que cuando Dios manifiesta su gloria,
it does something to your faith.
Le hace algo a tu fe.
That's why in Matthew 28 He says, I will never leave you and I will never forsake you.
Por eso en Mateo 28 dice, nunca te dejaré ni te abandonaré.
In Psalm 91,
Salmo 91,
He who abides under the shadow of the Almighty.
Aquel que habita bajo la sombra del Omnipotente.
John 15:1.
Juan 15:1.
Abide in me and I will abide in you.
Habita en mí y yo habitaré en ti.
God's presence.
La presencia de Dios.
Is confirmation.
Es confirmación.
That He is with me.
Que él está conmigo.
That He will never forsake me.
Que él nunca me abandona.
That's all I gotta know. Is God with me?
Es todo lo que yo tengo que saber.
That's all I gotta know. Is God? Is there anybody that feels God's presence?
¿Habrá alguien que siente la presencia de Dios?
Is there anybody addicted to the presence of God?
¿Hay alguien adicto a la presencia de
Dios? Is there
Dios?
Anybody that loves to seek the presence of God?
¿Hay alguien que le encanta buscar la presencia de Dios?
Who loves the presence of God?
¿Quién ama la presencia de Dios?
In the presence of God,
en la presencia de Dios,
faith will start to rise.
La fe se aumenta.
I had a pastor,
yo tenía un pastor
look at me in the eyes,
que me vio en los ojos,
and she said to me this,
y me dijo esto,
you came at the right time.
Viniste al tiempo preciso.
Check this story out.
Mire esta historia.
So these pastors,
estos pastores,
had been watching me on YouTube.
Me habían visto en YouTube.
And they had been watching, and he said that he got set free in one of my videos.
Y dijo que se liberó en uno de mis videos.
And so all of a sudden they hear word that I'm coming to the city.
Y de repente escuchan que yo vengo a la ciudad.
And that I'm coming to their church.
Y que yo voy a su iglesia.
They nearly passed out, he said. Because he knew that God was about to shift something in his life. You know what his wife told me? His wife said, you came at the right time.
Dijo, vino al tiempo preciso.
Because I was about to give up in ministry.
Porque yo estaba por darme por vencida en el
ministerio. But the presence of God that I felt,
pero la presencia de Dios que yo sentí,
caused my faith to rise.
Causó que mi fe se
levantara. The presence of God in your life,
la presencia de Dios en tu vida,
it just makes faith rise.
No más hace que la fe aumente.
Matter of fact, stand to your feet. Listen
hecho,
to what I'm going to say. Listen to what I'm going to tell you.
Escucha lo que le voy a
decir. Hear me.
Escúchame.
When I pray,
cuando yo oro,
I am a presence seeker.
Yo soy alguien que busca la presencia.
I'm very sensitive to the presence of God.
Soy muy sensible a la presencia de Dios.
I am a seeker of His presence.
Soy una buscadora de su presencia.
Porque cuando salgo de ese lugar,
because when I come out of that place,
hay una fe que aumenta.
There's a faith that rises.
Hay una fe que causa que pueda decirle a la montaña que se mueva.
There's a faith that causes me to tell the mountain to move.
Some of you,
algunos de ustedes,
some of you,
algunos de ustedes,
not all of you,
no todos,
you need more presence.
Necesitan más presencia.
And if you're going to strengthen your faith,
y si van a fortalecer su fe,
you've got to stay in the presence of God.
Tienen que quedarse en la presencia
and
de
abide
Dios
there.
Y habitar ahí.
When you abide in the presence of God,
cuando habitan en la presencia de Dios,
confusion leaves.
La confusión se va.
Frustration leaves.
Frustración se va.
Every situation,
cada situación,
that you're facing right now,
que enfrenta ahora mismo,
He will give you word about it.
Él te dará palabra sobre
he
eso.
Will tell you exactly how to fight it and what to do.
Dirá exactamente cómo pelearlo y qué hacer.
He said to me when I was in New Zealand,
me dijo a mí cuando estaba en Nueva
Zelanda, I was in my prayer closet,
estaba en mi closet de oración,
and I was preparing for 10 sessions that I had to do,
y me estaba preparando por 10
and I will
que
never forget
y nunca se me olvidará
the encounter that I had,
el encuentro que yo tuve
in the closet,
en el closet,
because I literally heard the voice of God.
Porque yo literalmente escuché
and
la
he said, daughter,
y dijo, hija,
will I not do it?
¿Acaso no lo haré?
Will I not do what you are asking me?
¿Acaso no haré lo que tú me estás
¿Sabes
pidiendo?
Cuando me lo dijo?
You know when he told me?
En la presencia de Dios.
In the presence of God.
¿Sabes cuando he oído su voz?
You know when I've heard his voice?
En la presencia de Dios.
In the presence of God.
En la presencia de Dios.
In the presence of
es
God.
Cuando toda duda se te va.
It's where every doubt leaves.
Todo temor se te va.
Every fear leaves.
En la presencia de Dios.
In the presence
es cuando
of God.
Sales segura.
It's when you come out confident.
Sales lleno de fe.
You come out
sales
faith.
Tan segura.
You come out so confident.
Sabiendo que tu Dios
knowing that your God
lo va a contestar.
Will answer.
Que tu Dios lo va a hacer. Busca la presencia de Dios. Busca la presencia de Dios. Quédate en la presencia de Dios. Vive tu vida a tal grado donde eres consciente de la presencia de Dios. Everybody near me will hear me say, do you feel God's presence? Because I want to know, do you feel the presence of God? Si tienes la presencia de Dios, no hay nada que el Señor no pueda hacer para tu vida en la presencia de Dios. Yo he visto los más grandes milagros en la presencia de Dios. Yo he visto rompimientos en la presencia de Dios. Yo he visto toda duda irse en la presencia de Dios. That's why my goal in this church is to invade with the presence of God. You won't be able to go even into the parking lot, because in the parking lot you will feel God's presence. The minute you walk through those doors, you will feel the presence of God. The minute you walk into this room, you will feel the presence of God. Porque la presencia de Dios, la fe aumenta, la fe aumenta, la fe aumenta, la fe aumenta. You need more presence. En la presencia de Dios es donde la fe empezó a aumentar en mi vida. I have faith to believe Him for absolutely anything. Anything. If there's cancer in this room, I have faith to believe that cancer will disappear at the sound of my voice. There's enough presence in this place to move and shift every situation. Ahí aumenta la fe. If you are doubting, if you are fearful, run to the presence. Worship Him and run to the presence. When you don't know what to do, when you've got fear, when you've got doubt, say, God, I am going to be transparent. I believe you, but help my unbelief. When you are doubting and when you are scared and you don't know what tomorrow will bring, obedécelo. Obedécelo, obedécelo. Si te dice levanta manos y adórame, obedécelo. Cuando te dice tráeme sacrificio, aun cuando no tengo, tráeme sacrificio, obedécelo. Cuando tienes dudas, tienes temores, el diablo te está atacando. Entra a su presencia. Entra a su presencia. Y ahí descansa. El Señor te dará la instrucción. El Señor te dará el qué hacer. El Señor te va a resolver ese problema. Porque Él es tan bueno. So I'm going to ask you to do something. Because I can feel His presence. I can feel His love. And He's going to begin to invade every person in this place. Esa presencia empieza a aumentar una fe. Aumenta una fe. Aumenta una fe. Every person in this place, that is in this place, every person watching me, you say, Apostle, that message, I need to strengthen my faith right now. Run up here. I've got 10 minutes with you. Run, 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 run. Run, run, run. Run, 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 run. Run, 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 run. Run, run, run. Run and lift your hands up in this place. Lift your hands up in this place. Lift your hands up in this place. Nobody looking around. Nobody looking around. Seek Him and you will find Him. Seek Him and you will find Him. Levanta tus manos y búscalo. Búscalo, Él está ahí. Búscalo, búscalo, búscalo. Él está aquí. He's here, He's here, He's here. If you need to say sorry, go ahead and tell Him you're sorry. If you disobeyed God, if you disobeyed God, if you disobeyed God, tell Him you're sorry. In this place, my God, I'm not gonna do it for you. You shall do it. worship Him. Just worship Him. Lay aside everything. Be transparent before Him. Abre tu boca y dile la verdad. ¿Cómo te sientes? Be open and honest with your Father. Dile cómo sientes. Dile, dile en tu propia boca, con tus propias palabras. Open your mouth and tell Him. If you're scared, tell Him.
Si tiene temor, dígale.
Doubting His character because you know He's good.
No dudando su carácter porque tú sabes que
just God help my unbelief.
Dios ayuda mi incredulidad.
Strengthen my faith.
Fortalece mi fe.
Strengthen my faith.
Fortalece mi fe.
Strengthen my faith, God.
Fortalece mi fe.
Strengthen my faith, God.
Fortalece mi fe.
Tell him, strengthen my faith.
Dile, dile, fortalece mi fe.
Strengthen my faith.
Fortalece mi fe.
Dile tú, dile tú, dile tú.
You tell him, you tell him.
In His presence.
En su presencia.
Every shackle has to fall.
Toda cadena se tiene que caer.
Every chain and every bondage.
Toda cadena y atadura.
All doubt has to go.
Toda duda se tiene que ir.
All fear has to go. Everything has to go that does not belong there.
Todo se tiene que ir, lo
cast
que
your cares.
Echa tu ansiedad.
Cast your anxieties.
Echa tu ansiedad.
Cast it on Him.
Échaselo a él.
Everything that is dividing you.
Todo lo que te está dividiendo.
From believing God.
De creerle a Dios.
From trusting in God.
De confiar en Dios.
Cast it upon Him.
Échaselo sobre él.
Dáselo a él.
Give it to Him.
Todo lo que te molesta.
Everything that bothers you.
Dáselo en esta noche. In the name of Jesus. Jesus. I declare in this place, shackles are breaking, God. Father, in the name of Jesus, they take up their shield of faith. 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 They pick up the shield of faith so they can extinguish every fiery dart of the enemy. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Levanta el escudo de la fe. Levanta el escudo de la fe, iglesia. Créele a Dios. Créele a Dios. Créele a Dios. Créele a Dios. Believe him. Believe him. Father, today we move every mountain. We move every mountain. We move every mountain. Every need in this place. Father, I declare right now, every mountain moves. Every spirit in the name of Jesus has to evacuate. In the name of Jesus, we order, God. We order, God. We order today your hand to move. Your hand to move. Your hand to move. I feel something is moving. Take up your shield of faith. Abre tu boca y empieza a declarar. Needed in this place. I declare right now, in the name of my God, I feel faith. My God, I feel faith. You gotta open your mouth and begin to declare the miracle. Oh, shut the gate. Declare the miracle. Declare the miracle. Declare the miracle. In the name of Jesus. Father, we order every miracle to manifest in the lives of your people. Just needed. I order right now healing to manifest where healing is needed. Right now, I order in the name of Jesus financial breakthroughs, family breakthroughs, 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 sudden checks, sudden checks, sudden checks. I order it right now. Abre tu boca. Decláralo. Decláralo. I feel deliverance. I feel deliverance. Move down out of the way. Tell it to go. Start to declare your future. Declara tu futuro. Decláralo con tu boca. Abre tu boca. Declara tu futuro. Prophesy. Prophesy to that thing. Tell that mountain to go. Order that mountain to go. Church, open your mouth. You. Order that thing to get out. Order that thing, move it out of the way. 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 In the name of Jesus. Father, we declare the faith of your people is rising. 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 In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Oh God, we love you, Jesus. Some of you will have to start saying thank you. In the presence. In the presence. Faith rises. In the presence.
Your faith rises.
Oh God. In the name of Jesus. We declare breakthrough. I declare breakthrough. I did it in Bryan, Texas. And I will do it for this city. I will do it for this city. I will do it for this city.
Yo lo haré para esta ciudad.
En el nombre de Jesús.
In the name of Jesus.
Eric, I can hear her. In the name of Jesus. I declare right now. In the name of Jesus. I order breakthrough. Breakthrough. I order breakthrough. For every family. For every woman. For every man. I order breakthrough. Breakthrough. My God, somebody pray with me. Pray with me.
Oh.
strengthen your faith. Strengthen your faith.
Fortalece
tu fe.
Strengthen your faith.
I can't hear you. Strengthen your faith. Strengthen your faith. Begin to worship him. Begin to worship him. Begin to worship him. Begin to worship him. Worship him, worship him, worship him. Worship him, worship him. I feel something's about to move. Something's about to erupt. Worship him, worship him. Strengthen your faith. Strengthen your faith. Strengthen your faith. Tell him I love you, Jesus. You are awesome, God. You are awesome, God. We worship you, God. You are beautiful, God. We love you, Jesus. Oh, we love you, Jesus. We love you, we love you, we love you, Jesus. Abre tu boca y adóralo. Adóralo, 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 adóralo. Don't you let him take your faith. Don't you let the enemy take your faith. You, God.
Te alabamos, Dios.
Mountain moving God.
Dios, que
that you
montaña.
Are.
Tú lo eres.
We praise you, God.
Te alabamos, Dios.
We believe you, God.
Te creemos,
you
Dios.
Are the God of the impossible.
Tú eres el Dios de lo
Almighty
imposible.
God.
Amo.
Eres hermoso.
You are beautiful.
Pecho. God, thank you, Jesus.
Gracias,
Jesús. That's why I'm addicted to his presence.
Por eso soy adicta a su presencia.
That's why I'm addicted to his presence.
Por eso soy adicta a su presencia.
I've been in times in his presence where I feel like a giant.
Yo he estado en su presencia donde me siento como un gigante.
It's there you're strengthening your faith, church.
Ahí es donde fortaleces tu fe, iglesia.
Stay there a little longer.
Quédate un poco más.
Thank you, Jesus. We love
Gracias,
you.
Jesús,
we
amamos,
honor you.
Te honramos.
Thank you, Jesus.
Gracias.
Te amamos, mi Padre. No hay nadie como tú.
There is no one like you.
Eres hermoso.
You are beautiful.
Come on, just stay there one more minute.
Vamos,
can you just stay there?
Más. ¿Te puedes quedar ahí?
Gosh. Thank you, Jesus. You're beautiful. God, we love you. We love you. We love you.
Jesús, hermoso eres.